two, one. Hey, welcome to Geek-Cetera. Obviously, I'm not Wild Josh, and I'm joined by Chase and Ezra. Josh can't be here tonight. We asked him about it. He said, hey, I can't talk about it. We pressed him a little further. He said, look, my wife said it was for the children, so you guys figure out what that means. But we're here to talk about episode 6 of WandaVision. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's get geeky. All right, guys.
Wait, who are you again? Because I kind of forget. You haven't been
not
here.
Not Wild Josh.
Oh, okay. That's just your name now. Cool.
I'm the reverse.
You're Stanley.
My name's Kyle. For those of you that don't know, I used to be here on the podcast, and now I play a little behind the scenes. I'll actually be doing a video coming up pretty soon. That's a book report. No, book review. How's that sound? On Light of the Jedi.
Fancy.
And we also have a Who's Who coming out on the Jedi from Light of the Jedi that you guys can look to.
I'm
excited. We're so off topic for the start of this video, but I'm excited for us all to finish Light of the Jedi so we can do a live stream on it and I can tear the book apart.
Yeah. You're going to have to do that after my book report. Yeah. Because, yeah. Anyways, we're here to talk about WandaVision episode 6.
Are we now?
That had to do with the, what was it, the very special Halloween special? That doesn't sound right.
A spooktacular something?
Spooktacular sounds good because we know what we're talking about. Well, let's kind of dive into that. Where do you guys want to start? I forget where you usually start. Do you start with where the episode got its
all new Halloween spooktacular? Looked it up.
All new Halloween spooktacular. Thank you very much.
Yes.
And this kind of opened up with the '90s. Well, not really '90s. Late 2000s. '90s, early 2000s.
This is 2000. Absolutely 2004.
When Malcolm in the Middle started.
No, but I'm going with the fact that later in the episode, when they're outside the movie theater, it says The Incredibles.
Oh. Okay, fair enough. But it also said The Parent Trap.
Yeah.
Double feature.
But Parent Trap.
Yeah.
Also
yeah.
Been that same. 90.
That was 98, but The Incredibles.
Okay. Was the new right. Parent Trap 98, really? But you can still play movies long after they've been out.
You can, and you can play them before they happen.
No. No.
Fair enough. But let's kind of talk about that.
98. Jeez.
So I'm also like, this is giving me like Sweet Life of Zack and Cody vibes because they're twins.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of.
What does that make you? A Dorkosaurus Rex. It very much gave me Zack and Cody vibes.
Yeah. Which, if you're like in, you know, me and Chase's generation, then there's no way you didn't watch that show, like at least once.
Mm-hmm. Or Sweet Life.
So were you guys satisfied? Do you think that was a proper setting? Are you mad that they skipped the 90s?
No.
I don't know. Because, like, a lot of the 80s show, I mean, I don't know. Is there, like, a defining thing about 90s shows in particular that's different than early 2000s shows or late 80s shows? What do you think, Kyle? I mean, that's more your probably.
He's calling you old.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm calling him slightly older than us, is what I'm calling him. Yes.
Yeah, 90s shows, especially the sitcoms, were a lot like the 80s shows. So yeah, I don't mind skipping, especially when they're turning the focus to the children. So it's going to be more like the Disney kids shows or like the Nickelodeon shows. So I'm fine with it. Didn't mind it. In fact, I enjoyed it.
Yeah, I did too. Yeah. I thought it was good. I didn't mind that they skipped the 90s necessarily. Unless next week we get like the real 2000s and there's some like actual difference and we're like, oh yeah, that makes more sense. Like this was actually the 90s and. Which I don't know. I kind of think it was. I think it was. I'm with Chase. Like that, it was set in the 2000s.
I said incredible, so I have to feel like that's 2000s. And I said that to one of my coworkers too, and she hadn't even caught that. She's like, "Wait, how did I not see that?" And I'm like, "Oh, just use your eyes."
Wow.
But yeah, that was like during that scene. I was like, "Oh,
and
the Incredibles."
That's
why
no one wants to work with Chase.
Fair.
Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, I liked it. I thought it was a good setting, and I don't know. And it was really proper, especially for Pietro, for a first episode with the fun uncle. right?
Mm-hmm. Wait.
So if you guys don't have anything more to say about that, where do you want to go next? So, do you want to talk about the story itself or where the characters are at?
I would actually like to talk about Pietro for a second, because like I'm thinking it is very funny to me. Like this, he definitely, the actor channeled his past experience playing Pietro and not necessarily like Pietro how he is in the MCU, I feel like. Because like Pietro in the MCU, I don't think was as goofy or as like, you know what I mean? I think it's definitely a different character we're seeing, which is a little weird.
Yeah.
So like part of me really wants to believe that this is like, this is actually how they tie in the X-Men, like, and kind of canonize the Fox X-Men movies.
So why do you say that? Because he didn't reference his other life, right? He didn't reference.
Well, and this is like that. I'm trying to think about that. Because yeah, I don't know. It just, why would he be different? Why would he be any different than just because she recast him? Wouldn't he be exactly the same?
You're making a fabulous argument.
Well, I'm sorry. I didn't really think that far through it about it. I just like, that's my observation. And I'm trying to bounce it off other people, and they're not saying anything. So...
I agree with you. I was just wondering where you're coming from with that, only because you're saying this has to be the Fox tie-in, but he doesn't. I don't know if he doesn't remember his other life. He definitely doesn't talk about it. They talk about why he looks different, but he's pushing that back on Wanda.
I'm kind of like under the impression that.
Hold on, wait. I want to go back. Sorry, you said that he doesn't really remember any of his other life.
He doesn't remember
a life in Wakanda. Wakanda. Oh my gosh, Sokovia.
The other one. Which in the Fox.
Wait.
Movies.
I might be lost because I wasn't entirely paying attention because our live chat wasn't working, so I just got rid of it.
Oh, is it gone now?
Yeah, I just switched to the other screen. I don't know why it's not working. I'll have to figure that out later. But
okay. Anyway.
Doesn't he talk about the trick or treating and?
Yeah, he talks in Sokovia.
And Sokovia.
He never lived in Sokovia in the Fox movies.
I see. I guess I just don't care enough about Fox to know what you guys are talking about. Never mind. My bad.
No, he grew up with like only his mom, and he didn't know who his dad was. And then he later in the movie he finds out that his dad is Magneto. Right?
Yes.
So yes, it like that was, that did strike me as weird too, that he wouldn't talk about that life. Not his, like, why would he be talking about his MCU life and acting like his Fox character? It's like I don't know. I'm kind of like wondering if he's also under or whatever, or if he's, because I mean he asks her questions like you know, what do you do, like how did, you know, how are you doing this, and like stuff that the other brainwashed people don't even recognize, right? So it kind of seems like
breaking that fourth wall.
He's, yeah, exactly. But like at the same time, I'm kind of wondering if he is brainwashed, because he's not talking about his life. If I am to believe that this is the Fox Quicksilver, he's not talking about his life, you know, his past life. He's talking about like this like made up past life that Wanda has, you know, like brainwashed him to believe is his. That's kind of what I'm thinking. I don't know. Does that make sense?
It does make sense. So here's the other thing that I'm going to throw out to you, because I agree. I think this is a good tie-in to bring in the X-Men, but but I don't know if they're going to be using any stories, like backstories, anything from that that part of the multiverse, right? Perhaps it's just the character who might become an X-Men, but he's from a different Earth. Like, he doesn't have that same backstory.
Yeah, yeah. So, like, kind of what they did with Spider-Man, right? Because, like, this is why I thought they were gonna just, you know, those Fox movies, those happened, but just in a different multiverse. Because, like, that kind of makes sense to me, because they didn't care to go back and give Spider-Man a backstory. We've already seen it in movies before, right? We've already seen the X-Men's backstory in the X-Men movies. So why bother revisiting it? Why not just continue building with the stories that we have, right? And that's why I thought, like, that's perfect. They could literally just be like, all of these movies are canon, just in a different universe, but we can take characters out and use them in our stories going forward. That's why it made sense to me, because that's essentially what they did with Spider-Man, except not really. So maybe they are going to do exactly what they did with Spider-Man and just kind of like, the backstory isn't important, but we're still using the exact characters, if that makes sense.
It makes total sense, especially when you consider that Andrew Garfield and the original Spider-Man from the Sam Raimi series. I don't know why I'm blanking on his name, Tobey Maguire. They're going to be in Spider-Man Home. Is it Home Again? I think it's Home Again.
Let's go.
Like, they're rumored to be there. So, yeah, I think you're spot on, and I think this is one of the first
which one
we're gonna get.
Which one's spot on? The one that they're canonizing old movies, or that they're just gonna leave that ambiguous and like
that they're bringing in Evan Peters as Quicksilver, just like they're doing the same thing with Spider-Man. That's where I think you're spot on.
Okay, all right. Because
also,
like
the other things you said.
Okay, now I'm confused. It's okay though. Because like I would love it if they did exactly that and were like that. You know, Kevin Feige came out and said like, yeah, you can basically treat the Fox movies as canon, like if that's what you want to do. Because to me that like leaves no room for new origin stories that like people no doubt will ask for, you know, like for those people who like definitely want backstory, it's already there. Just go watch it. You know what I mean? Like, we don't have to worry about like, is there going to be a like prequel to, you know, Quicksilver or whatever, where we learn about him in the alternate universe. Like, it's already there. It exists. Like, just, you know, I kind of like that idea. Like, I think that'd be kind of cool if they did that.
I agree. So let's pivot though. Let's stick stick with Quicksilver. What or who do you think he is? Like, is this a real person? It's a larger question because I'm not sure where you guys are on Vision, but I guess,
yeah.
Is it open-ended? Who or what do you think this Quicksilver is? Is he dead? Like, is this a reanimated dead body? Like, where do you think, what do you think is going
so
on?
I think he's
that's
the
interesting.
Same. Go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, it's completely within her power to create people. She made Billy and Tommy. She
that's
fabricated
what I was
going to
say. I think he's like the kids.
Real,
I think
she also made them with her body.
Well,
let's not discredit the moms here.
I don't think that, yes, can she do that? Yes. But is that a thing that actually happened? I don't really think that's what happened.
Yeah,
because I think that would require the other person to be alive.
Yeah.
And maybe not a robot.
So what do you have an opinion? Let's take Billy and Tommy out of it, because I think Vision and Pietro are kind of connected. But I want to see at least what you think Pietro is. Do you think he's... This is where I'm at. I think he's a reanimated dead body. I don't know. But that's where I think he is. What do you think?
If he was a reanimated dead body, I think he would have the same face.
And why is he... Where did she get this dead body? because she's not going through the rubble of Sokovia to find Pietro's corpse. Like, what's the actual probability that she even finds that?
Oh, I'm sure they brought him home. Are you kidding me? He's probably in a casket somewhere in the ground. They probably found his body and, like, put him in a casket and buried him.
Sokovia kind of buried itself, so you're really going to be, like, digging up? I don't know.
Actually, now that I said that...
I mean, that's what
I'm,
you do with fallen soldiers, right? You get their body and you bring them home.
I'm going to backtrack on that because I think it's a little faulty, and here's why. So this is where I originally was. I think Vision is Vision... I think she went and got the body. I'm pretty sure because in this last episode, they said that Kat Dennings' character said that the head of S.W.O.R.D. right now is tracking Vision because he's tracking the...
vibranium decay.
Degrading vibranium.
The decay signature of vibranium. I don't think it's degrading. It's the same way you track a half-life of carbon.
Okay.
So I think they might just... Because vibranium is such a rare substance... If they're tracking the half-life of vibranium, sort of like when you're carbon dating something, you track the half-life of carbon, they could use that to locate and see inside where he is. So I don't think the vibranium itself is degrading. It's just, it's a metal, so you can track the half-life. That's how I see it.
All right, fair enough. But that's still...
So I don't think his corpse is, like, disintegrating is what I'm saying.
Well, he kind of was disintegrating at the end of the movie, the end of this episode.
Good point.
But besides that, they just said they were tracking the vibranium signature, right? Mm-hmm. So that to me tells me, oh yeah, that's Vision. That's the body that she pulled. And we saw that she saw the same body with the, you know, the Mind Stone removed.
When
she pulled the body. So I think Vision is that body. I don't think it's Pietro. And the reason I thought it was Pietro is because she again saw that monochrome, saw him as a dead person. But if she went and got the body now, years later, the dead body wouldn't look like that. That would indicate it'd be bones, right? Yeah. That's what she'd see. So I actually don't think Pietro is a reanimated dead body.
I don't think so either. I would like to also, because like for those of you who are like me and was thinking while he was saying this, like, what was I thinking? Oh, that she can just manipulate matter and change it. But I answered my own question because I was thinking she can't actually do that because like even though she like changed matter and like, with what's her face's clothes?
Monica's
like, clothes. They were still made out of Kevlar. They scanned it and it was like, oh, yes, it's made out of Kevlar. This is my bulletproof vest. So she can't actually like change matter into something else. She can manipulate it though somehow.
She can alter reality.
Yeah. So I don't know whether that necessarily means she can change matter. I don't think she can fabricate vibranium is what I'm trying to get at here, because she couldn't change Monica's clothes into a different like whatever cotton or whatever fabric, it was still Kevlar. So I'm under the impression that she can't just like change a like gold into vibranium or, whatever it be. Like, I don't think she necessarily could do that or would do that. So I do think you're right. I do think that it is Vision's body because it's made out of vibranium. I agree with that. And I also think you're right that it's not Quicksilver's body either. I think that's kind of why she recast him, because she couldn't reuse his corpse. So as far as like the original question was, what do you think he is, or who do you think he is? There's what I want to believe and what I actually believe. And what I want to believe is that he's Quicksilver from, another multiverse where the Fox movies are canon. But what I think I believe is not that. But I don't really have an answer of what actually it is that I would believe.
My answer is that this is just a fan service cameo. I don't think it leans to anything or means anything.
Want it to not be like that.
I know, but I just think like that's. I think it's a cool way to pay homage to that kind of stuff. I don't know.
No,
I don't think that's true.
It's Disney. It's probably not, and it would be. I don't know why they wouldn't just go get the original actor if it didn't mean anything. That's just my thoughts because I don't know enough about the outside, like, universe. I don't know enough about the Fox properties and all
honestly,
of that. So.
Honestly, in my opinion, it probably would be even harder to negotiate a new contract with a new actor than to make a new contract with an existing actor that you already had a contract with. I think because you've already worked with his agents. You've already worked with him. You already know that he's like, he is on board to do this kind of thing. So I kind of think that there's got to be a bigger reason for why they went out of their way to cast the same actor from a different movie series. I don't know. I really want to believe my thing is true. What do you think, Kyle?
No, I think there's, I definitely think there's something larger at play. And I think the X-Men are coming. I don't know when, but I think this is the first step to get there.
So can I sidetrack us for a second?
Absolutely.
Are you done with what you're saying? I'm sorry. I kind of interrupted.
Yep.
Okay. So basically, if this is true, it'd mean that Kevin Feige's a liar. Because wasn't he saying that, which was, I don't know, maybe not even a year ago now, I don't think. He said, like, we at this current moment, we have no plans to bring in the X-Men, even though, like, there was news that they could potentially do that. So if that's true, and Kevin Feige is capable of lies,
it means that then Star Wars is coming to the MCU.
That's kind of what I was getting at.
Yes, I'm sold. Stay tuned for a future video on what that's all about.
But I think they kind of have to keep that stuff under wraps. Because
no, I agree. I'm just kind of being silly. But
no, I know. But Evan Peters' cameo was actually teased or hinted at a long time ago. And Disney threw a bunch of shade at that.
Yeah.
Basically, it was not to be believed. And that was like 6 to 9 months ago. Mm-hmm. So it could be that he's just really trying to bury it. So it is a surprise.
Throw us off the trail, essentially. Yeah. Okay.
Let's talk about Billy and Tommy a little bit. They've had a couple episodes, but this was definitely more centric on them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Especially just the way the episode was portrayed from the
kind of like 2000s. The walk along, like I don't know which ones are which.
Breaking the fourth wall.
Yeah, Tommy was kind of like, or Billy. No, Billy was talking to the cameras.
So, what did you guys think of where they're at?
They haven't aged up yet. I don't know much else. It'll be interesting to see, like, now that they have these powers or abilities, if it like forces them to age up again, or if they're just gonna stay as kids for the rest of the series, because everything kind of developed so quickly and now they're kind of paused on this moment. So I don't know.
What do you think they are now, Chase? I know you had some opinions last week or even the week before.
Did I?
What do you think they are? Or who?
I don't think they're real people is the thing. Because everybody else that's been in there has, you know, they've found the real life person. And Wanda's, especially when they talk about in this episode, you know, Pietro says, you've done a good job with, like, the ethical considerations. I don't think she's just going to steal, you know, these kids and then, oh, I don't want these infants, trade them out for the next model. Oh, these toddlers are garbage, get me some 7-year-olds. I don't know how old they are. But yeah, so I don't think she's like trading out kids. And so since they don't really fit in this whole picture, I think that she's made them up or like created them. I don't know. It's very weird. This whole show hurts.
So if they go the route that the comics did with them, right? Because like they're already kind of are at this point because Billy and Tommy were made up by Wanda. They weren't really real. They had superpowers. One of them had Quicksilver's powers and one of them had Scarlet Witch's powers. It's kind of what we're seeing now. So at the end of the, I think it wasn't House of M. It was the one before that like kind of built up to House of M. I can't remember what it's called. But anyway.
Oh, Avengers Disassembled.
Maybe it was the one before that. No, it was the Scarlet Witch in the Vision. Or the Vision in the Scarlet Witch, or whatever that one was.
Yeah, the miniseries.
Yeah, at the end of that, they don't exist anymore. But they come back. Like, they actually join the Avengers as, like, real people in another comic book series. So I don't know. I don't know exactly how that happened in the comics.
So,
but I don't know if they'll go that route.
Maybe.
But
do they use the multiverse to make them exist kind of thing? I don't know.
Could be.
Because we've been talking about, and they've been, you know, we've been theorizing with how Wanda is going to be part of the big reason with the multiverse in the Doctor Strange movie.
Yeah.
So this TV show could kind of be like an intro to the multiverse.
So I definitely think that's
true. And that
could
be where they get Evan Peters as well.
And I like your reasoning. I didn't. So the reason I thought that was true, that this was going to essentially set up the multiverse for Spider-Man and for Multiverse of Madness, was because I thought that she essentially opened the multiverse when she pulled Pietro out of it, like, and I think that's what starts this whole chain of events, whatever they may be. I think she started it in that moment when she pulled Pietro from another multiverse. Is kind of like the theory I'm working under right now, like what I think is going to happen, kind of to a degree.
So okay. Do you think that
because they didn't make any? I was waiting for them to say specifically that they could not ID who this was.
Yeah.
Because I would think that'd be like number one on their priority list. It was to try to figure out who it was. Like, why'd she recast Pietro? Who is this man? Where did she get him from? But they didn't even talk about it in the episode, which I was kind of upset about because I was like really tuning in for that specific detail.
Well, what was going on?
And
what was going on that side? So you're talking about Sword, right?
They literally, yes, I am. They literally ID'd every single person that they saw, and it didn't. They have like, you know, this database to look under. It would not take that long to run like a facial recognition and try to figure out who it was. I don't think what was going on necessarily would affect that. I think that would be their priority number one, because like Kat Dennings' character, I never can remember these names.
Darcy,
like, had so long between when she figured out that he was, like, recast to when they kicked them off the base to figure that out. And I don't know why she didn't, or why she didn't even look, or maybe it was, like, not on camera, like, behind the scenes. But, like, I don't know. I really think that they should have talked about that. And they probably didn't because they want to make it anonymous for like a surprise, but that's what I was tuning in to see. Like, that's why I was irritated. I didn't get to see that. Where was I going with this? What were we talking about?
You were talking about Pietro and you were frustrated that they didn't identify that he was or was not a person.
What are we talking
about?
Because
the multiverse. You're waiting for that.
Yes.
She's opening
so,
the multiverse.
I was waiting for this episode to be the answer to like whether or not he came from the multiverse or not. Because like even if they said this is not like he doesn't exist they can't ID him. That honestly would have been like the answer for me. I would have been like, okay, I'm convinced now.
My question is, do you think if that scenario is true and she pulls him out of this multiverse, that, you know, because he would obviously be quite confused. Do you think she's still controlling him and is kind of keeping him somewhat like fourth wall breaking to like reinforce herself or to like keep her own mind in check?
So
do you think like when this hex ends, he'll go back to being like, whoa, where am I? Where's Scarlet Witch?
I think she has to, because there would be no good reason for why he's playing it cool at this, you know what I mean? Like, he just got, oh no.
Do we have a Josh?
Oh, yep, no, we did. Uh-oh. Okay.
If we have a Josh, I can just stop and we'll have all four of us, but.
Well, that's fine. We can do that. It's just, I knew it was going to break the stream. That's why I said.
Just for a quick second. It's good though.
Oh, just is the stream going. Broken?
I don't know. Anyway, he said something in the chat.
Yeah, he said, sorry, I hit the wrong button.
It's okay. What was I saying before that?
Something I had asked about, is she kind of controlling him and keeping him as a fourth wall?
He just got pulled out of like another dimension.
Yeah, he would be so confused if that is the... Mm-hmm.
So I think she would have to mind control him to a degree. Mm-hmm. And maybe that's why he's not fully mind controlled, is because... I don't know, maybe he's harder to mind control because he's
powered.
In a more confused state.
Or because he has powers? I don't know.
Yeah, that could be.
I don't know.
Or she doesn't feel like she has to because she trusts him. Or at least she did before he made that comment about how your husband died twice.
Yeah, so that was the thing that like really bothered him. He's like, I'm not a stranger and I'm not your husband. I'm like, but you are a stranger. She has never seen your face before. You're in here pretending to be her brother, but you're not the Pietro that died in Sokovia.
Well, okay, but here's the thing. You guys are talking about things like it's hard to have that conversation without getting kind of to the heart of the matter, right? And that's, what is Wanda in control of and what is she not? Or who's in control, right? So what is your prevailing theory now? Because I know there's been a couple, but we have another episode. I know, Ezra, you said in the comments, you know, you have more questions than answers, but where do you think Wanda is right now? And what is she in control? Let's start there.
Okay, I'll start, because I hate that every episode that goes by, Ezra is more and more right and I'm more and more wrong, which is annoying to me. That's never a good start. And she definitely proved that she is entirely in control of this power field around the hex when she, like, expands it. And I was like, oh boy. I still don't think that she started this or that she entirely understands what's going on. She's definitely in control, but I think her mind is in an altered state, either like I don't think through mind control, but something is messing with her. Even just with the fact that she always says, you know, when Pietro asks, "Oh, how are you doing this?" or "How did this start?" she always says, "I don't know. It just kind of is here." So, I don't know. Ezra's definitely right, though. She is definitely the power source.
The mind is capable of a lot of weird things. And I think the mind is definitely capable of blocking out trauma. Mm-hmm. And I think, and the way it handles trauma is sometimes very weird. And, like, I think that compounded with superpowers, mm-hmm. like hers, especially being, like, mental... How much of this is controlled by... I don't think we're... I think... I honestly think, yes, her this area is being controlled by multiple sources. I think those being her conscious and her subconscious. I think that her subconscious is controlling more of it than maybe her conscious mind is, but... I think that's why she's not capable of remembering how it started, was because she's part of her's blocked out that trauma, yeah. And most of it is her subconscious like taking control of like her powers.
I just don't understand. Why is this taking so far after the fact then? Why didn't this happen in like during that 5-year blip? Like, this happened after they defeated Thanos. I would have thought that she would have.
She was dusted though.
No, she was not.
She was not?
No. No.
I don't think she was.
No, she was. Because was she? Now I'm going to have to look it up.
How do we not remember the biggest event in Avengers movie history?
It was like the original Avengers. It was none of the new guys that were not dusted, but let's look it up.
Because I remember her fighting against Thanos, but I guess I feel like...
She came back in Endgame.
Yeah, she was unstopped.
After the... Yeah, she was dusted.
She was dusted, okay.
Yeah, never mind, so. Then... I'm not getting an actual answer.
Cool. She was dusted. There's a picture. I see. She was dusted.
Okay. Yeah.
Then that makes... Okay. For some reason, I was thinking that she had not been dusted, and I'm like, why? She's had so long to recover. You also say that it was only the originals, but technically Ant-Man is not an original Avenger, and he survived.
Yeah, but
he was in the quantum realm.
That doesn't have an impact to me, because when Thanos snapped, half of all life in the entire universe was gone.
Yeah,
and I would argue that the quantum realm was part of the universe.
I would kind of agree with you.
So Ant-Man survived. I just got a text from Aaliyah saying she was dusted, and Josh in the chat saying Wanda was dusted. They all probably think we're idiots,
except for me.
Except for whatever, Kyle.
Just you and me are idiots. It's okay.
Yes.
All right. So let's keep this going. Chase, you make a really good point. Why is this happening now after Infinity Endgame, other than the fact that she was dusted? But think about this. When the reverse snap happened, or we're calling it the blip now.
Yeah.
Most everybody got people back.
Yeah.
Wanda didn't.
I was going to say that as well.
Yeah, it's true.
Yeah.
That's tough.
I think that might even be harder to deal with than them dying in the first place. Like, everyone around you,
I don't know,
having reconnected with their family again and being happy, and everything in the world is right except for your life, which is still screwed up.
And it's just weird how they show the different ways that people deal with trauma, because I would argue that Hawkeye lost way more than Wanda did. Hawkeye lost his family, his wife, who he was actually married to, and his kids, all three of his kids. And he went off and was still doing stuff. He was doing bad things, but for a good reason. He was taking out, the basically triads or the Yuza, saying, why should you have gotten to live?
Or an anti-hero.
Yeah. But then, even when he gets stuff back, he still lost Natasha, who was his best friend. But Wanda loses her... Did Josh call him a sex doll or an e-boy, whatever? Wasn't that what Josh said last week?
It was definitely the first one, yeah.
Yeah, so...
Kyle's like...
I lost my train of thought with that, though. But yeah, so, like, she lost literally a piece of code, and she goes into, like, this nightmare regime.
She lost a piece of code, but clearly she's still suffering from the loss of her brother.
That,
like,
too,
people got their families back.
But he's been dead for a long time. He was long before.
There's
we've had this argument.
Time limits on grief is arbitrary.
I understand that, but like, I would still argue that Clint lost way more, and his fall to the dark side was not evil.
Well, kind of it was, but also he has no powers. So he can go on a murdering spree, but he does not have the power to just bring his family back in an altered reality. Hmm. It's a sliding scale.
You're not wrong. I still like my point of view, though.
The other thing, too, is like... We've had this argument before where you're like, you even said, like, wouldn't she feel more like hurt from losing her brother than like this robot? This robot is her husband or her boyfriend or whatever. Mm-hmm. Like, would you not feel worse if you lost, you know, your mate rather than your sibling? I mean, I know that's a tough comparison to make, but like,
Ezra, you don't understand. Vision gave her life-changing experiences. Like, she used to speak Sokovian and have that accent. He changed her accent. He changed her world. You don't understand. You can't put your head in her headspace.
I am arguing for that point.
Oh, then you can understand that headspace. Thank you. You're a genius.
Yeah, exactly.
But think about that. So Wanda helps save the world. In her mind, maybe, everybody gets something back. So... you know, it's not much for her to say, I helped save the world, I want something back, so I'm going to get my husband and just take over a small town.
But that seems like, why does she need to, like, take over these people's lives? Why can't she just go find some nice mountains in the Himalayas that nobody's inhabiting and just create her own little self-sufficient world?
I don't know.
Like, but... why does she have to own... this town that because okay, that, yeah so... that's one thing is there's no imports or exports from this town. Like, what are they surviving on?
Yo magic.
But we already went over that.
I said that they were also just... twins, so that's more than just siblings, which I guess they were also twins.
That's true.
Yeah, because then they would have been together much longer. They would have had a stronger connection. But still, Clint lost three kids.
So let's take the why out of it, because we'll probably get those answers. What is the most likely scenario right now? Is Wanda in control?
I think she is.
Okay, subconsciously, or maybe even with a split personality?
Yeah, I mean, I think... Yeah, I think her as a person and her subconscious and conscious are in control. I don't necessarily think there's an outside force or has to be.
I'm sticking with no. I think that it's her power, but I don't know. I have a hard time seeing this be her alone. Like, I don't think it was her idea to come and kidnap a town. I was going to say a small town, but now she owns way more area. You could probably say that she's probably doubled the size of that area now.
I wouldn't be surprised if all of the things that she did up to this point are just like a blackout moment. Like, she was so moved by her own grief that she did all of this stuff and she just completely forgot that she did it.
Or subconsciously, consciously split personality. Or
yeah,
there is just a part of her that doesn't care. And this is kind of where I'm landing. Like, who is the TV show for?
Yeah.
Nerds.
No.
Like the broadcast that Wanda is sending out that Darcy Lewis found.
No, you're right. Also nerds.
Clearly, because Darcy Lewis found
Like, why? Who's the audience? Who the show is directed at?
I don't know.
Besides Wanda,
that's I've said something similar. I don't think we have an answer for that.
I personally think the show's for Wanda. I think whoever is really kind of in control and calling the shots is the one that's enjoying the show. So she's letting the innocent or whatever Wanda play out. But when something happens that doesn't go the way the Wanda that's in control wants, that's when she stops watching and she kind of grabs the controls.
Yeah, I don't know. This episode was the first episode I've argued with Ezra several times about this. I've always said that, you know, if Wanda is in control of this whole thing, like, all of the outside, not like the outside, but like something happening in the next house wouldn't be happening. She's not individually controlling this. And this is the first time we see when Vision goes to like the suburbs that are like close to the border and everything is kind of like glitched or broken. Nobody's moving. Nothing's happening.
I'm so glad you mentioned that because I'd forgot that I won that argument.
I hate you. Maybe I shouldn't. No. All right. We're ending the podcast here.
What do you remember the argument that Wanda and Vision had at the end of episode 5? Some of the arguments she was making point directly at what you're talking about. Mm-hmm. She's saying, if I was controlling everything, I forget exactly what she used, but like, make sure these people were mowing their lawns or whatever. Like, she'd have to control every action. But then you see, the farther you get from the power source or the Minecraft chunk, as I like to say, right? She only loads certain sections. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what she's doing. But on a very, very, very small basis. At the end of this episode,
she turned up her render distance.
She's got to turn up her LOD.
So there could be someone profiting or helping things along and taking advantage of this state. Mm-hmm. But I think a lot of it is Wanda. And here's another reason why I think it could be. Have you guys heard who the next... So I'm not sure if it's going to be this aerospace engineer, but there is a character that we know.
We haven't even talked about that yet. The aerospace engineer.
We'll come back to it.
Yeah, we have to come back to that.
That's a huge part.
Yep.
But have you heard about the character that's coming? Because this character plays into Young Avengers. This character is going to play into Wiccan because he has a strong relationship. Have you heard?
No.
The Hulkling is coming. It's a character that was rumored a long time ago, but we know, and I forget his name, but he's already been cast as like a boy next door. So we know this person is going to be in town, but it's the Hulkling, and he is going to be a Skrull, I believe.
Ezra's headed to the Google. I don't.
So
I feel like Hulkling Kyle's is in Young Avengers. Chains.
What's that?
I said I feel like you're yanking our chain.
No, I'm not. Hulkling, first of all, in the comics, is the boyfriend of Wiccan, Billy. So there's probably going to be a relationship there. But he's also part of the Young Avengers, and this is another reason why I think Wanda's in control, because the fallout from losing Billy and Tommy. In Pietro and potentially Vision, right, at the end of this. I'm not saying that's what's going to happen, but it could. That would also affect Hulkling. Like, I just feel like having these personal ties to these other characters that she's created makes it more likely that she's done this, and it's going to have implications for the new characters that are coming in.
Very interesting.
Interesting. These are things I didn't know.
Yeah.
So, that's all. But let's talk about that aerospace engineer. What did you want to talk about?
I don't really know. Like, I think we just need to talk about him, because he could potentially be Reed Richards, is the most popular theory. I don't know that there's, like, another really good idea. He could just be nobody. But those are the two. Those are like, as far as I'm concerned, those are the two most likely. It's either Reed Richards or it's just completely nobody.
I suggested it could be Leopold Fitz from Agents of
S.H.I.E.L.D. I think that's a great idea.
It's probably so unlikely. I think it's the most probable option is they go Reed Richards. But
so he's the only one in the Marvel universe that specifically is an aerospace engineer. I mean, Leopold Fitz is an engineer, mm-hmm. not necessarily an aerospace engineer.
Built a spaceship.
I know he built a spaceship, but that's not his title. Like I don't think that's so.
That's not
I don't
what
know
he
why specifically. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know that she'd specifically say he's an aerospace engineer just because he's an engineer and he built a spaceship. I mean,
yeah,
those kind of go hand in hand, but that's not his exact mm-hmm. his exact wow, what was the word that you just said? Like his fields. Yeah, yeah.
So Reed Richards would be exciting. There's a chance it could be the Hulkling. I doubt it because that's not his character in the comics, unless they're trying to combine a couple characters into that one. It could be Hulkling because if he's really a Skrull, that could help Monica get back into Westview, right? So that's maybe where this character could come in. Wait, I'm going to throw another X-Men tie-in out there. And the only reason I'm throwing this out is because we saw in this episode, and we haven't talked about it, right? Monica has some change going on in the cells in her body, and that's possibly how she could get powers. And that's kind of what I'm thinking, especially now that we've seen Wanda's powers kind of expand Westview and take in more people. But that could happen, and maybe that's where the X-Men get their powers, is like right here through her powers. And I'm thinking the aerospace engineer could be Hank McCoy, Beast.
Yeah,
it would fit more with those X-Men tie-ins.
Yeah, I had read an article that suggested that as well. Again, he's not specifically an aerospace engineer.
Yep,
he's not even an engineer. I wouldn't say he's a scientist. He's think physicist. He also plays with chemicals, though, so maybe he's a chemist. I don't know. But I don't think he's an engineer, per se.
Yeah.
So I don't... I like it, but I don't think it's probable, given, like, the data that we have.
We did have a brief conversation before we started the podcast with Josh while he was still here. And the name Mark came up, and so I suggested Mark Ruffalo, which would be Bruce Banner. But he's not an aerospace engineer. He's a genius with a doctorate and somebody with a personal connection to Wanda through the Avengers. So he was also another possible name that could come up.
Maybe. I'm just realizing Monica was also snapped. So yes. This would really have to be someone that she knew a long time ago.
Mm-hmm. Like the Skrulls, she's known since she was a kid.
Right.
So this is kind of like... maybe a reason why it wouldn't be Reed Richards, because like, if he's been around for a while, well, I guess maybe his origin just hadn't happened yet. He's not really a superhero right now. Right? Maybe because of this event because they all got their superpowers together, right? Mm-hmm. So I don't know that necessarily.
What do you think is the likelihood that they change up? Oh, Kyle's got a child, I think. But what do you think is the likelihood
that they bedtime.
Change up the origin story of some of these characters if they're gonna do the Fantastic Four? Or something like that. Like, there's nothing saying they have to keep the origin.
No, that's true. For some reason, I don't think they'll do it for this set of characters, but I can't explain why I think that. Their origin story kind of ties into the fact that he is an aerospace engineer.
Mm-hmm.
So if they're keeping that aspect of him, why wouldn't...
Yeah, why would they?
Mm-hmm.
That's fair.
Yeah, so I don't know, but they could.
I just really feel like if it's going to be a big character, something would have leaked, right? Like the Evan Peters or the fact that they were going to bring in Hulkling, or because it's all Disney, right? All the cameos that happened in Star Wars: The Mandalorian,
like Luke Skywalker or Grogu.
Okay.
They've proven they can, like, I understand there's tough. Grogu was, I don't know how they kept it, because that one was a major character in the entire first season.
Sure, I know, but I'm talking about, like, if you're like, signing someone, you didn't have to sign someone on to have Grogu.
Okay, that's fair. If you're talking about actual signing. that makes sense. But they have proven that they can keep secrets.
Like, my mind shut off for a second. What are we talking about?
Kyle said that there's
who this aerospace engineer is.
Oh, okay. If it's going to be a major character, why hasn't anything been leaked about it yet?
Unless it has, and we're just not getting John Krasinski, right, as Reed Richards.
Is that even a watchable version then?
I don't know.
I'm kind of there with you.
If we're not going to get both Jims in the show, like, why?
Who's the other Jim? What am I?
Oh,
Asian Jim.
Asian Jim.
Yeah, you're right. Both. Oh my god.
Find out this.
Yeah,
Friday.
We would have both Jims on the exact same show. Wow, I like that. That'd be hilarious. We are gonna figure it out. Are we gonna figure out this Friday? You think?
Yeah, absolutely.
She just left.
They left and saw the hex growing behind them. They're. Yeah. She's not making any stops.
So they're rendezvousing with the aerospace engineer. What if the rendezvous point was in the area that got expanded? What if he's like in the hex now?
It's an hour away.
No, he's not.
Was it an hour away? Okay.
Well, yeah.
Oh, and so that's the thing. So I finally did some digging on that on her phone. So I was really trying to get some analysis, zoom and enhance on the text that Monica Rambeau did, and our detective team can't do what they do on TV. Mm. But after some digging, I found that her text said, the top said messages, right? So there was no name. It said messages. In the little circle was just, you know, the outline of a human. So there's no real hint there. And then the message said, I'll be there in an hour. So there was real, and it was a phone number. So there's really no clues for us in that message.
So she doesn't even have the contact saved in her phone. She just knows the phone number
by heart.
Weird.
Yeah.
It's Captain Marvel.
I don't know. But there's no clues there, except it. I mean, the meeting spot was an hour away.
Not an astrophysicist. She's not an aerospace engineer. That's the one. Yep.
But she did work in aerospace testing. Carol Danvers was a test pilot.
She's not an engineer, though.
Who's saying she didn't go get her doctorate during the snap? Other planets had the Avengers. She had to go to college classes. Like,
she wasn't even like on Earth. She just was like, screw
even
Earth.
Even better, she's taking aerospace engineering classes from people who could actually travel in space and not the lousy humans who don't know anything.
Lousy humans.
Yeah, what a bunch of idiots.
Do they even have like? Do aliens have like, you know, college and like certifications? Do they value pieces of paper that say you can do certain things?
They're not cavemen.
Who's to say we're not the cavemen for valuing those things?
We probably are.
We most certainly are. We can't travel in space. Well, we can't just not. We can't travel through hyperspace. Or through
we can't
light speed.
Go anywhere in any meaningful amount of time.
Yeah.
All right. So is there anything else that we haven't really covered? I'm trying to think.
Well, let's talk about the expansion at the end. Because that clearly would have taken up a lot of power to do, because she turned all of those things, or like all those things got transformed, and now she has a whole like encampment of sword agents that she has to mind control. Also, why is it a circus?
I don't know.
And it looked like, so the only people that didn't get swallowed up were the director in his car and Monica and Jimmy Woo.
Didn't he get swallowed?
True.
No.
He did not. He did not.
He should have. That would have been funny.
Yeah.
So what do you think the implications are?
I don't know. I feel like there's probably a reason that they wanted to get Darcy in there. I wonder if she's going to be a huge factor now that she's inside the hex. If she can kind of...
Well, I kind of was already thinking she was going to go in the hex ever since she said
Yeah.
You can't go back in there because it would change your molecular structure or whatever.
Yep.
Because I was like, well, then just send Darcy and that solve problem solves.
Yeah. So I wonder, because like Monica clearly retained some of her, like some of her knowledge. So I wonder if now that Darcy's in there, they have a much better understanding of this whole situation.
That's kind of why I'm thinking that people with more knowledge of the situation and what's happening are less susceptible to the mind control.
Yeah.
They're more able to retain their own thoughts and like, so that's that to me kind of might suggest that that's why Quicksilver is able to kind of speak out of character.
Yeah. But so what about Agnes then? Because last week she said, do you want me to take that again? Like, yeah, so are we implying that she has more of a base knowledge as well as to what's going on?
Well, we kind of are under the impression she's important one way or the other, right?
Yeah.
But what if, again, going with this, Wanda is in control. What if when something happens Wanda's not expecting, she loses more control because she has to focus on what the issue is that she's trying to correct?
Well, this would also play into my theory that it's happening in her subconscious. Her subconscious is mostly controlling the entire thing, because the more she's consciously aware of the situation, the harder it is for her subconscious to control it. I like that a lot. Thank you.
So while she's aware of it, that's why the people in like the outskirts where Vision is aren't moving. They're just kind of like stuck, because she's having that conversation at the same time she's having that conversation with Pietro at the hay bales.
Her subconscious only needs to trick her conscious self that it's real. So nothing outside of her vision or needs to be like moving. That detailed.
Yeah. That's interesting.
Yeah. Or like that's why Agnes and what's his name, Roy, were able to have a conversation, because they weren't like in that same room, but they were close. They were close enough in proximity to what was going. Sorry, I'm going back to episode 3. Mm-hmm. But when the babies were being born and Wanda was just in there with Monica, you know, Agnes and Roy were able to have a conversation with Vision that was like more on the level, because they were loaded up, right? They were in proximity enough where she could kind of have them active and not in that brain dead state and crying.
Do you mean Agnes and Herb?
Herb, thank you. Agnes and Herb, right?
Yeah.
Like they were close enough in proximity. They were let go out of the scene.
Mm-hmm.
But then what about the doctor? Because the doctor was clearly much farther away. And Vision was able to go there, have a conversation with that doctor, and bring him back.
Yeah.
But Vision... But
Wanda has to keep the scenes going for Vision, so she's kind of at least keeping... That's not even
How would true. She know where Vision is, though, if he's not within inside her field of view?
No, that's a good point. Unless... I don't know.
Like, I can understand her keeping, like, his office setting going, but, like, when he's out on neighborhood watch, how would she know like where he is?
It's planned or part of the script, right? So Vision running to get the doctor, she knew he was going to get the doctor. Vision being on neighborhood watch, she assumed he was going to be on neighborhood watch and in the neighborhood, so she didn't have to load the outskirts of town. She didn't know he was in the outskirts of town. I don't know.
No.
So then what about the script tells Vision
actually
to... Okay, go ahead.
I'm kind of going back on my theory now, right? Because, like, there's multiple elements here. Maybe the broadcast isn't for Wanda, like you said. Maybe it is. It isn't.
Who's it for?
Maybe that's where, like, an outside factor comes into play.
Okay.
Like an
who on
AM
the outside
or...
wants to watch WandaVision?
I mean, we watch it every week, but that's not what you're asking. I don't know. I don't know because like, there's we were working like so hard to come up with this theory, mm-hmm. and we were like so close, and then there's all these like holes in it, and so I'm trying to fill them in. The show
is just, it's insane. It's literally insane.
I love it. I think this is great.
I don't think that, you know, we all loved The Mandalorian. I don't think any of our talks about The Mandalorian, any of our live streams, were as deep. Or
and you as, weren't even excited as for lost. This. And you were like, you said you weren't probably gonna watch an episode, and then just
I
like,
was not planning to watch this. And then I'm like, God, if we're gonna live stream every Monday night our reactions to the episode, I'll watch it. I was also expecting it to just be a sitcom. I wasn't expecting this to be.
How were you not expecting that? We talked about this before this even aired.
I did, but I saw the trailers, and I'm just like, no, this is literally just like a 60s sitcom. I don't want.
Oh. Oh, Chase. All right, so we're kind of... Where are we right now? So we talked about the power, more people being brought in. Can we talk about Yo Magic? What exactly is the message there?
Yeah. I read a theory that... Like, the shark has struck her. And he's giving Wanda her powers, and that's what Yo Magic is, you know? But I don't really, other than that, like, I have no clue. Like, that was just super confusing to me.
Yeah, I don't know. It was by far the weirdest commercial I think we've had.
Ooh. If she doesn't figure out how to open it or use her powers, she's gonna die.
All of the other ones seemed like messages in a deeper sense. Like,
well, the other ones were all connected to her
like, past.
Her past and her traumatic experiences. Like, for instance, the Stark toaster that ticked like a bomb because she was caught underneath like a bomb that could have gone off.
Yeah.
The watch was Strucker, right? Strucker,
yeah.
Basically radicalizing them.
Lagos. Paper towels.
What was Lagos?
I don't remember entirely. Hold on.
Kyle, you remember.
As soon as I look it up, I'm going to be like, dumb, stupid.
Come on, Cheese.
Hold on. Give Google a second.
It's a city. Oh, that's where. Okay, Lagos is a city in Nigeria. That's where she blew up people by accident. In Civil War?
Yeah, so at the start of Civil War, before the Sokovia Accords.
Mm-hmm. Were there other ones?
One, two.
We only have gone through four. We should have. There should be one more that I can't remember.
Yeah, I can't either. But the other ones have been pretty obvious.
Yeah. Well, let's see.
That's why Yo Magic just sticks out to me. I could. This is the it's one di- that it no, was just.
It's different for sure, 100%. Like I don't think it's just a reference to a past trauma. I think it's almost like a premonition. It's like maybe future events. Like it could be predicting or foreshadowing what might happen.
Or what's going on now. I just the only thing I can really connect it to is the people on the outskirts, right? Like if they're not getting what's that?
Hydra soap.
Hydra soap. Oh, that's right.
Because you know that's why I make
my nose ring soap.
I've had so many conversations with Aaliyah. She keeps mentioning that one, and I always forget it.
This one just in my head, and I can't pinpoint it, but I draw a mental connection between that commercial and the people that Vision sees on the outskirts of town. Mm-hmm. I feel like those people could die if they're not loaded.
It's weird because Jimmy does say too, he's like, there's no movement, there's not a lot of movement from people on the outskirts. Are they dead? And then the next scene it goes and shows Vision like flying around the area and nothing's moving. So
All right, so anything else?
Till next week.
You guys are pretty quiet. Let's talk. We got three episodes left. Where do you think this is going? And I don't think any of us will be right.
None of us will be right.
Okay. I think that the obvious one, right? The director of S.W.O.R.D. is going to have to end up working with Monica.
All right, so I'm gonna one up you right here.
And her team.
I'm going for the way more obvious option, and the director of S.W.O.R.D. is going to end up dead, obviously.
Why?
I mean, he's already tried to kill Wanda, and she made dozens of his men point guns to his head. I think that if he ends up in the Hex within the next 3 episodes, Wanda is going to go ballistic.
The reason I think they're going to end up working together is because at that point it's his only option. Because he and them are the only ones on the outside that know what's going on in there. But I think they're going to have to work together.
I don't think he's in contact with them. And
My prediction.
Yeah, I know. And I have a hard time seeing Monica being like, you just kicked us out. Why, what do you have to offer us, especially now that you don't have an organization behind you? Like, she had this plan to already go in on her own with Jimmy Woo and this airspace engineer, whatever.
Like, I mean, he's the director for a reason. He's got some things to offer. And at that point, he's...
I don't think he does.
They manage the numbers. He basically has to do what they want to do because... doesn't have a choice.
But I don't think he has
four of them and one of him. So either he worked with them or he doesn't get anything done. Like I don't know. That's the way I see it. I think
he set
it up so that he's got other resources too.
I think they've set him up as enough of a bad guy where they can kill him off and nobody feels bad.
Okay.
That's my bet. But I still think this whole show ends up my original, we did a video on who could be the next big bad guy in the MCU, and I said Wanda. So if my initial theory of Wanda being controlled can't be right, then my truly original theory of Wanda being the bad guy is where I'm going.
I 100% agree with that. I think Wanda's, by the end of this, everything that she's created is going to be taken away from her, and that's going to... cause a mental breakdown. She's gonna be
sets her up as the bad guy for the multiverse of madness. Yeah,
I 100% agree with you there. Cause like we know she's gonna be in it. They never said she was gonna be a good guy. They never said she was gonna work with Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
So I think she's gonna be the bad guy.
And she is powerful enough to warrant them going into the multiverse to get reinforcements or help. So.
Yeah.
I agree. I agree with Chase. I think Wanda's going to end up being a villain. I don't know if she's going to be the overarching villain of this phase.
No, she's a minor villain.
But I think she'll last a few movies. I think she'll last into Spider-Man. I think she'll last into Multiverse of Madness. And I think she's going to play out in at least a couple of these Disney Plus series and could last into Young Avengers. And I'm going to go for a long play and say that... Vision, you know, he's not going to survive this series. Nope. Maybe Pietro, if he's really from another multiverse, maybe he'll survive and maybe he'll go back. But I think Billy and Tommy are going to survive for a while, especially because Hulkling is coming into this series. And they're all going to, those three are going to end up in Young Avengers. However, at some point, they're going to go away. Like, her consciousness, they're going to either be destroyed or she's going to realize they never really existed and they're just going to fade out of existence, and that's going to be a big negative plot point in Young Avengers. So that's my long play.
I'm going to probably disagree with that and put my guess on that they will not survive to the end of the show. I think they'll bring them back later is what's going to happen.
Yeah, I think bringing
them
back...
just like they did in the comics.
I think killing them off or making them go away at the end of the show helps sell Wanda's spiral to evil more than them sticking around.
And
though I don't know, I could see it both ways, because if, say, Sword is in control of them, or they like help out Sword, and she's kind of betrayed by her own kids, and yeah, you know, is now working against them, that kind of the mental aspect of that would be bad too. Like you took them from me. How dare you?
I can see that. I'm not changing my stand because
I think I'm originally
I
with
be different.
You, but I can see both options.
I could see it. I could see it for sure. I think so. Like I talked about last week, I think it's entirely possible that they bring back Vision for good, not at the end of the show, but I think they can do it in the future. Did you watch last week's episode, Kyle?
Maybe that's how they get Ezra, not Ezra. Maybe that's how they get Wanda to turn back good, is they actually bring him back.
I think that's going to be part of it. I do. Because like what I was saying last week is like his existence is made up of like a couple different aspects, right? There's like Jarvis, and then her the Mind Stone, right, is what makes up his personality, which essentially she has the Mind Stone is what was removed from him, and she has the power of the Mind Stone. So I think she's essentially just using her power to supplement what was removed from him that killed him. And that's how she's reanimated him. So I wouldn't say it would be like completely like unreasonable to say he could be brought back, because I think Jarvis is still in there somewhere. He wasn't killed. I mean,
if he couldn't be killed by Ultron, I don't think he's going to be killed by that. Yeah.
Shuri was doing her best to remove those two aspects. So and she got what seemed to be pretty far. So I think that Jarvis, being the fighter that he is, probably survived. And I think once, you know, that the Mind Stone is reintroduced into him, he could live again. So if she, I don't know, somehow with her magic powers does that, I don't know. I think it's completely feasible that could happen. What do you think, Kyle? That's my theory.
I like it.
I'd like to see it play out.
Well, especially because, like, Vision is awesome, and we saw him get beat up, like, a bunch of times, and that's pretty much it. Like, we didn't really get to see him kick butt as much as he really should have, because he's pretty cool. That's my thought on it. I'd love to see, like, him come back and be really cool. Yeah. So as far as the show though, I think Vision and the kids are going to die, and I don't think Pietro will, because I think he's from a different universe. And I think that's how they're going to open up the multiverse madness. And I think they're going to kind of like explain the multiverse by the end of the show, at least a little bit, kind of introduce it, get our appetites wet for that kind of thing. So
yeah, I would definitely like to see them introduce the multiverse now. I think it makes it easier for the people going to watch the movies who have watched the show kind of connect things. So
I like it. I like it. I think, is that good? Are we good?
We're good.
Good.
All right. Hey, before we cut out for the night, don't forget, we have beautiful merch, and you can find that on TeeSpring, and it's
true.
Absolutely supports us, and we make money off you. However, if you love it, get it, right? How can we deny you the pleasure of our merch? Anywho, tell us what you think. Oh, poor Logan. What did you say? He was awesome at being a punching bag. He was awesome at being a punching bag. Thank you for your final word. So that's kind of it. Don't forget to like and hit the subscribe button, and send us lots of messages telling Josh you want him back on the show, and hopefully whatever was for the children worked out for him. We'll find out probably tomorrow when he has 17-year-old twins. That's it. Until next time, for the children.